pleasure to answer every prayer. His peace will guard your heart. His peace will guard your mind through his Son, Jesus Christ. And in the middle of a struggle, there's
a good day. I'm pleased that you've set aside time again to be with me as we are looking at focusing on renewing our minds. Today we're going to look at practicing navigating by the Kingdom of God GPS. We live in the days of the GPS. And this GPS, the Kingdom GPS, I refer to the Kingdom values, the values of the Kingdom of God. How do we, as God's children, use the Kingdom GPS or adhere to God's values? We do so by prioritizing God and His righteousness. Christ taught us in Matthew 6:33, but seek, aim, and strive after, first of all, His kingdom and His righteousness, His way of doing and being right. And then all these things taken together will be given to you besides. Now, I just want to draw your attention to the Greek word that is used here for seek. It is a Greek word that is used when you're looking for something that's hidden, where you require more effort to look for. There are other Greek words where, for example, in the next verse, they talk about seeking the things of the world. These are, you seek things that you desire. So the effort, you can see that the level of effort is different. But you exert more effort when it is coming to seeking God's kingdom and His righteousness. And in James 4, verse 7 and 8, we read, submit yourselves then to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. And verse 8, come near to God, and he will come near to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. I mentioned earlier about the word seek that is used. It is a word used for looking for something that is hidden, where you require more effort. I just want to point out here, it's not that God is hiding from us. God wants to come to us, but it's just that we are focusing more on the world. We are battling in relating to God in the right way. And that is why it's as if God is hidden from us. Now, we should continuously submit, we should continuously surrender, we should yield ourselves to God from Sunday to Sunday through obeying Him and His Word. We should not be Christians on Sunday and on Monday we do things in a different way and we don't seek God, but we should seek God on Sunday, on Monday, on Tuesday. It's a continuous process. Now, the devil will stop bothering us if we resist him. We must resist him. That's what we've read in James chapter 4, that we must resist the devil. Now, it is me who must seek God, and it is also me that must resist the devil. No one is going to do this for me. It is something that I must pay attention to and do it. Now, again, I just want to refer you back to Romans 12, verse 2, that spells out the responsibility of renewing our minds. What that verse says is that I must stop striving being like the people of this world. I have to allow God to transform my mind, my way of thinking, through His Word and the Holy Spirit. I must realize that God does not impose Himself on me. I have to let Him renew my mind. It is my responsibility. And no one, not my pastor will not do it for me, the deacons or the elder or whoever. It is me. It is between me and God. So it's something that we must really pay focused attention to. And it is only if we do this that we then will begin to organize our lives according to the principles and to the righteousness of God. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we are grateful that You have given us Your Word, and Your Word contains Your principles by which You want us to live. And therefore, Lord, we pray that You may help us to pay attention on Your Word, on following it, studying it, meditating upon it, and practicing it. And we pray, Lord, that we may resist the devil, who always wants to distract us and prevent us, Lord, from living according to Your Word. In Christ's name, Lord, we pray. Amen.
Be still and know that He is God. Be still.